Won't you buy me something to eat? Yeah. Buy me something to eat. Buy me something to eat. Won't you buy me something to eat? Yeah. Won't you buy me something to eat? Buy me something to eat. Won't you buy me something to eat? Yeah.
I'm Jeremiah Jones, author of the Glen Notes series. Glen Notes 1 and 2, it is available on Amazon.
That's how you gonna say
it? Yeah, that's all I'm gonna say.
You do taxes?
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah.
You know now,
yeah. Yeah, no, I definitely know some people that can get you right on your taxes, EFT taxes. We eat some real good food right now. Yeah, you know, I'm an entrepreneur though, for real, so. That's what I like. I just like to keep my hands kind of tied and into a little bit of everything.
So we're gonna go ahead and get into the question. Well, yeah, we at Gators Dockside. Yeah, we at Gators Dockside.
Yeah.
Yeah. Excuse me. And this is like my second time eating here. And this is the first. I thought all they had was wings, but you know they got other stuff. So I got this salad. I will put a clip of it.
We had some gator tail, y'all.
It was good. Tastes like chicken, y'all. So, go ahead. Okay, you said you write books and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So what made you come up with the first book, the whole series?
Well, the first book, I always wanted to write a book since I was in grade school. But as far as for the Glen Notes series, it was more about exploiting into my talents and also trying to lead this generation into a different path. So I feel like talking about the streets and doing it through character dynamics would be really good illustration for people to come and follow after and know the consequences of what they're out here doing sometimes. And the rewards too though, not just the consequences of making bad decisions, but the rewards of good decisions. And like I said, just making it through character dynamics, that way it's people that they can relate to. So that was kind of my whole method of doing it. I mean, all the process wasn't easy and stuff like that though, but it has had a good reaction. I appreciate everybody that's been supporting me as well.
So where did you come up with the idea? So you just sat down and you was like, I'm gonna write this book, or how did you put all that? It's a lot to write a whole book.
I mean, I really like to write, and I just knew that it'll open up different things for me, and the doors that it will open, and some of the things that it'll bring into my life, and what it can do for somebody else's life as well. So that's kind of what made me do it, and what just kept me motivated, and what kept me driven. And then I also wanted to finish. Like anything I start, I definitely want to finish. You know, that's just kind of like having a leader's mentality, or like a boss mentality, I would say. You know what I'm saying? Just having that discipline, just having that focus, having that grind, you know what I'm saying, to try to accomplish something and get to, you know, a point of success.
So the stories inside of the book, is they based off real stuff, or you kind of came up with them on your own?
I mean, it's based on some real stuff. Like, you know, I grew up in Eatonville, Florida, so, you know, over there it's very urban, you know, and it's a street environment, you know.
Almost everything tastes.
Right. And, you know, it's a very street environment. So, with that being said, that's why I was able to kind of illustrate some of that stuff into my book, you know, street violence, gang wars, how to dress a certain way, what type of cars to put in the books, and what type of attitudes and, you know, lifestyles the characters should have and be living. So that's kind of where I got it from.
Are you ashamed, you know, like coming into this whole book industry, it's a lot of, you know, uppity people. Do you sometimes find yourself being ashamed that you are from Eatonville, that you're from the hood?
No, not at all. I love Eatonville. I love Eatonville to death. Like, you know, I even gave contribute to it even before that at the back of my first book, you know, about the author section. And when I went on Channel 2 News, I also, you know, I was able to talk with Jasmine Bailey and just kind of tell her a little bit about the area when she acts. So I'm never ashamed. Like, you know, that's one of the oldest black towns, you know, in history, Eatonville, Florida. And, you know, we have great things over there. You know, a lot of business owners, a great mayor. The Martin Luther King Parade every year, the Zora Neale Hurston Festival, which she's a book author, you know, the first one before me from over there. So, you know, I love that area.
Right. What
was it, 1887? All day, every day, Calendar Park.
Okay, so how has writing this book, how has the process been for you?
It's been a long process. It's been challenging at times, very challenging. You know, sometimes I get to a point to where I kind of want to end it before I hit my goal mark, you know, but I always just keep going. I got people around me that'll push me to keep going and letting me know, like, hey, you should hit your goal, you know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what, you should hit your goal, you should keep going. And, you know, I thank God so much for them people that's in my corner, that has been in my corner. So it's just the motivation, you know what I'm saying? Just making sure you got the right people around you too. That definitely plays a big part.
How your food
tastes? It tastes good. How you want it?
This salad is snappy. It's called a summer salad. So, with your book, what are some opportunities that your book has brought you? Or what are some things, you know, that came to your lap from your book?
Financial progress, for one. Open door opportunities, and what I mean by that is sponsors, book signings, gaining fans, gaining supporters, spotlight, of course. And just being able to do a lot of different things. And you know what I'm saying? Like I said, just being able to show my talents. Like, you know, that's one thing that's definitely part of my life. And, you know what I'm saying? And just making me a better person. Just, you know, helping me excel and kind of get further ahead.
Do you feel like the success that you feel like it's changing you in a good or bad way?
I feel like in a good way. I mean, you know, I don't do a lot of things that I used to do before I became a book author. Because I know when you're a book author, you gotta carry yourself a certain way. I mean, when people see you, they think more about your books than they kind of do you as a person, if that makes sense. And what I mean by that is they expect you to conduct yourself like a book author. You know, that's the title that you carry, you know, and that's not a title that you want to take for granted. I mean, you really want people to respect you as that, that way they're into your products, they're into buying your products, they're into supporting you. And helping you in any way that they can, and you know, you helping other people, you know, always being available too. So, yeah.
Where do you see yourself with, you know, with your books and your series? What do you see it taking you 5 years from now?
5 years from now, I see it taking me nationwide, worldwide. You know, I'm really shooting to be international. I mean, you know, my first book, it was based on, you know, Michigan. It was based in Michigan. You know, my character Cyan Chad is based in Michigan. And then my second book is, you know, speaking about Marlo. You know, he's an Italian mafia gangster. So I wanted to tap into Italy and the different parts of Italy. So I actually had to study the map while writing these books, and both books actually, you know, learn the different states of America, learn the different parts of Italy and stuff like that. So I want to go international. I want to go global. You know, I want to go into other countries, into other states, into other cities, you know, and get into different ethnic backgrounds, you know, have them read, you know, my product. So.
Do you see yourself coming out with a series, like a TV series or like a YouTube series? Because that'd be dope.
Yeah, I want to get in the screenwriting. I want to get in the screenwriting. I'm not going to lie. I definitely want to turn them into movies after I do Glen Oaks 3, the final chapter. I might give people a bonus, you know, in the following years. I'm not sure yet, but I know Glen Oaks 3, the final chapter, is definitely coming out, and I want to get into screenwriting, you know, either before or after selling my copyrights. It really don't matter, but I definitely want to get into screenwriting and give people, you know, a movie series after the books, though, not just the books. So, yeah.
How you came up with that name, Glen Oaks?
Glen Oaks. I actually Googled the name to make sure that it wasn't a real live actual place. Mm-hmm. And I know, like, you know, I'm from Orlando, Florida, you know, pertaining to Eveville, but you know, I've been around Orlando a lot, and I always see Oaks at the end of a lot of like apartment complexes and stuff like that. I mean, Glen Oaks is actually a subdivision full of houses, you know, it's a project area in the book, but it's kind of hard for me to explain because I ran through several different titles. I remember I was writing all down, you know, I was writing down the suggestions of titles that I thought was good. And I remember I was just scratching them out, and then I just came up with Glen Oaks. And then it's funny because when I initially came up with Glen Oaks, that was my title. And when I sent it into the publisher, he had told me, he said, how about Glen Oaks, the street show no love? Put a subtitle with it, because Glen Oaks by itself just kind of sound boring. So then that's how we got the street show no love. And then the number two, I followed up with the subtitle thing by doing Marlo and the Italian Mafia, you know what I'm saying? Not just Glen Oaks Part 2. So, you know, discovering Glen Oaks, that title, like, it was challenging. You know, like I said, I just went down through a bunch of written ideas, and then I just kind of came in the flow, and I liked how it sounded, so that's kind of what I used.
You sound like me. Because this is supposed to be named Lily's Tummy. So, because you're not like to eat.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm glad I went for something.
Yeah, buy me something to eat.
So, what is some words of encouragement you can give somebody who's just trying to get out the streets, trying to just find a niche? Because in America, as a black man, African man, it's hard not to get sucked into the streets. Because that's what the love is for most people. So what kind of words of encouragement would you give somebody who's trying to be successful, do something different?
I mean, it's all about choices. You know, when I was living in the hood, you know, I seen a lot, you know, I done some things, you know what I mean? I done been around some people, of course, but it's all about choices, you know. For one, you gotta want to get out the streets, you know what I'm saying? You can't let it limit you. And you always want to be a leader. I mean, you know, no matter what nobody say, you gotta be your own man, you gotta be able to think with your own mind. You know, that's important when you're trying to get out the streets. And, you know, it does take financial progress to get out the streets, you know. So that's why some people aren't able, though. But you can go out there and you can get that opportunity. You can get that financial progress that you're looking for. You know what I'm saying? If you work for it and you put in the patience, the practice, and the time for it. So, I mean, you know, coming out the hood is never easy. You know what I mean? But it's well worth it, and it is very, very attainable and doable. So anybody that's trying to get out the streets, like, you just got to put your mind to it. You got to stay focused. You got to be ambitious. And, you know, you definitely got to talk to the Lord and, you know, just stay faithful.
So what's next with your book? What's next with you? What's next?
You know, as I said, Glenno Street is next. As far as with me, you know, I'm just trying to become a better person, like, you know, become a better book author, you know, do public speaking, seminars, conferences, start teaching other people how to write books, you know, other people that seeking to be an author and have that drive for it and that really want to do it. You know, and teaching them, and, you know, continue to read other products from other authors, you know, because it's always room to grow, it's always room to improve, you know. Just because I've accomplished it just don't mean that I'm not weak in certain areas, you know what I'm saying? I have a strength in a lot of the right areas, but it's still things, you know, I'm learning, you know, and, you know, that I still want to do with writing itself. So just continue to expand and continue to be open and just continue to learn and push forward. It's really what's best for me.
So I will be posting the link for the book in the description box. I'm gonna get me one because I want to read it. I want to see what's going on. So, you know, I like that hood stuff.
Yeah, it's dope. It's really dope.
So with that being said, we're getting to the fun stuff. So, would you prefer a bed with no hands or no feet? And tell me why.
I'll prefer somebody with no feet, because you need your hands to work. Like, you still need hands to make stuff happen. Like, you know, I know it's gonna be kind of hard to move around with no feet, but, you know, we can get you a wheelchair, some crutches or something like that. I can help you get around, you know, to pick you up or whatever. But you gotta have them hands. Like, you know, you use your hands to type, to open things, to do certain things, to read books, of course. So I would rather for you to have your hands for account money, everything.
I don't think you count money with your lips, so try to move it with your lips.
You're right. Nah, I need your hand. That way we pulling through fast. You know what I'm saying? Drop off of the money machine, count it manually by hand, whatever. I need the hands.
Who you listening to? What's your top five you listening to right now in your car? When you be in your car? Top five.
Big shout out to Tona Boy. I like to listen to Tona Boy. You know, he from my city, so definitely Tona Boy. Gonna. Future. I just got on 21 Savage. I like 21 Savage. Okay. Oh, and my favorite rapper of all time, Yo Gotti. Yeah, All the Hustle.
Why?
Why them five or why Yo Gotti?
Why Yo Gotti?
I love Yo Gotti. I love Yo Gotti Hustle. You know what I'm saying? I like how Yo Gotti put other people on. I just feel like Yo Gotti real. You know what I'm saying? He true to the game. He done been in the game for a long time too. You know, he never gave a black eye to the game, like he said on CMA. And he have features with a lot of other hot rappers that I like Lil Wayne, you know, him and Gucci before they had their little situation, Future, you know what I'm saying? I know he got a song with Lil Baby, put a date on it, like just a lot of people I like. And then he done discovered 42 Doug out of Michigan. I like 42 Doug a lot, like, you know, and I know some people out of Michigan. So I really like Yo Gotti and just how he kind of explored the different levels of the game and what he do for the game as well, even though he kind of slept on it. But I love Yo Gotti.
He put Young Blackstone too, right?
Black Youngster, she talking about Young Blackstone.
The crazy one. They be talking about a little bit bitch.
Black Youngster. He put Black Youngster on Moneybagg Yo. You know what I'm saying? There's some other people too, like Zilla them back in the day. Like, you know, he done really looked out for a lot of people coming out of Memphis, you know. And I really like your guy.
Marry, fuck, kill. So who would you marry? It could be anybody.
Who would I marry?
Like in the industry.
In the industry.
It don't gotta be like Orlando. It could be like
all of them. Dang, all the ones I want to marry, they already married though. If I had a chance, like just one of the main type chance, I would marry Nicki Minaj in the industry.
Why?
I love Nicki Minaj. You know, I know a lot of people say this about her, that about her.
I love her too. I love her hustle.
Yeah, I love her hustle. You know, I love how long she's been in the game. I love that she write her own music. You know, I love her business mindset and what she's contributed to Young Money. And I just love her as a person. Yeah, man, Nicki Minaj, fine. Like, she's fine. That's that baby. I love Nicki Minaj.
Like, she came in, how she came in, and she just, I feel like she came in with a purpose. She came in looking crazy.
Yeah.
And then after a while, she toned down. You saw the real her.
Yeah.
So, I like that.
Yeah, I like Nicki Minaj.
Who the fuck?
Cardi B. Cardi B, she hood, she real, she fine to me. Like, I just like Cardi. I like her personality. And I like her music too, you know what I'm saying? Despite anything else. But yeah, I will fuck Cardi B. I'll marry Nicki, I'll fuck Cardi B.
Who would you kill?
Who would I kill in the industry? That's a hard one. Who would I kill?
Who's somebody
you
think about? I don't like that.
It's really hard because, you know, almost any female rapper that come up, like, I'm kind of like in support of them, you know what I'm saying? Like,
well, who is somebody that you just don't really like their music?
I don't really like their music like that. Meg Thee Stallion. I don't really like Meg Thee Stallion.
Do you think she's pretty though?
I think she alright.
Or does she don't do it for you?
Not really. She alright. You know what I'm saying? She ain't just, you know, hideous or ugly or nothing like that, though. Like, you know. But she ain't the best looking thing either, though. You know what I'm saying? And her music be a little bit too aggressive sometimes. Like, I don't know if she got too much bass or like, I don't know what it is, though. Like, it just don't be that, you know, what I'm looking for. So, yeah, probably me at style. She'll be the one that'll have to go.
Tell people
something
that people probably
don't know about you, like, some of you.
You're just like,
nah,
he do that.
Nah,
I ain't know that.
I mean, I work real thoroughly and diligently. Anything I do, I work thoroughly and diligently. Even outside the book, that ain't what I'm talking about. Like, read my Bible. You know, I know we're having a conversation about that. And I want to read it in chronological order from Genesis through Revelation, because I don't feel like it's a lot of young people that are doing that. So that's one thing that I do that people might not know that I do. I do it every Sunday though. I do it every Sunday. I try to read at least 7 chapters every Sunday. And the reason why I pick 7 chapters is because it's 7 days in a week, and I don't read a chapter a day before I leave the house and go to work, because sometimes I get caught up. So at the end of the week, I'll go ahead and I read a chapter for each day of that week coming into Sunday. So I usually read 7 chapters or more. Sometimes I read more.
Y'all hear it, right? God fearing man. We pray before the meal too. And normally I just be praying on my own. But he prayed with me.
Yeah.
So that's what's up. Like, alright, what's your turn ons and your turn offs as far as a woman?
My turn on is like when they have like the white fingernails with the little white toenail polish. They help be done up, you know what I'm saying? They be jazzy, like, oh no, I'm just kind of, it's almost kind of like I'm weak for it, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I love in a woman, like a woman that take care of herself, that's like high maintenance, you know what I'm saying? That takes pride in her look and her attitude and her image, you know what I'm saying? And a woman that's real, you know, that's not scared to eat in front of you, that's not scared to take pictures with you, you know what I'm saying, or around you, you know what I'm saying? They're not shy in who they are. They're confident in their presence and themselves, you know what I'm saying? The heart and the mind and in their soul, like, they comfortable thoroughly, you know what I'm saying? Not just for the looks. So that's a big turn on for me. And then a turn off for me is just, you know, a female that don't want to do nothing, you know what I'm saying? Or a female that's disrespectful, you know what I'm saying? Or a female that don't respect their people or don't have good manners and stuff like that. So it's definitely a turn off.
So that being said, can you leave just some words of encouragement?
You can do anything you put your mind to. just stay dedicated, just work hard. I know it get tough. Like, you know, we go through unexpected challenges and situations and circumstances along the way, whether it's financial, sometimes materialistic with other people, certain relationships, you know, diminished friendships, certain things with family. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, just certain unexpected things within yourself too, you know, because we all still earn ourselves to a certain extent. So just always put in your mind to be better. And just to keep growing, like, no matter what, like, you know, get through that pain, get through them times of struggle, you know what I'm saying? Get through them times of sadness, loneliness, you know what I'm saying? Like, when they down and they talking about you, stuff like that, like, just keep pushing forward. And when they congratulate you and they uplift you, like, you know, take it and do the same thing vice versa. Like, congratulate them or uplift them as well. Like, you know, don't always be out to seek, you know, credit or a round of applause for yourself, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes be that round of applause for somebody else. Like, you know, get out here and network, you know what I'm saying? Explore, you know what I'm saying? Get to know people, talk with people, reach out to people. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. That's what we need to do as a generation, really.
I agree. Go ahead and let people know your social media.
So they can
find you. I'll put it right here.
My social media is jera.maya. That's my personal Instagram, jer.miahh. And then I have a page strictly for my books. That's called Glen and Oaks, GLEBENOAKS. You can type that in on Amazon as well to find the books, both parts, one and two. And then my Facebook is just Jeremiah Jones. I also have a Glen and Oaks series page on there. It's a business page on Facebook. So that's all my social media right there. And you can reach me by email as well, jjeremiah222@gmail.com.
I'm gonna try to put all that in the description box. I'm gonna text you. And then I'll put the links on there.
Alright.
You can get better with that. But alright, y'all. Another bit about me trying to eat. This kid getting bigger and better. Like, I got a book writer next to me. I might have the president, not Trump, Obama.
Yeah. Clinton. Yeah, we need Obama then. We need Obama.
Let me get, I'll take Clinton.
Yeah, I'll take Clinton too. Clinton that dude, nah. Clinton that dude.
But with that being said, how was your food?
My food was great. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to dig into it now though, but it looked well. You know what I'm saying? That gator tail was real good. I smashed that gator tail as soon as it came out. And then I happen to have sweet tea and lemonade that I got. That's real good and tasty. Like, this my first time eating that gator's dog tail too.
That's my second. I ain't even know they sold other stuff. But this some stuff y'all. Y'all trying to get fine? Come get it. And you got strawberry stuff on there? Stop being mean. Okay.
She's smashing the salad, y'all. She's smashing that salad. She doing what to do.
Y'all. It's
on. She out of there. Let me show y'all my tenders. I got some tenders. I ain't got no more to gator tail. I got them with a little ranch. I love chicken tenders. That's one thing about my love chicken tenders. I ain't got no more to gator tail. Show y'all. I smashed it already.
Alright, y'all. With that being said, I give gators about like about 8. It's a little chill spot. But I'll see y'all next week. Y'all go ahead and hit that red button, that like, subscribe button. Y'all comment, share. All the good stuff. I love y'all. Sitting here, guess I didn't make well. Got time and a story to tell. Started when I was 9 years old. Woke up and daddy was gone. I started hustling and they couldn't tell me nothing. Frontin' in the hood, trying to be somebody. My soul was on empty. I was searching for something. Tried to be good. Tried to keep from trouble. Living to